Hey guys, Raider here. Hope you're all doing great and having a fantastic day. Pretty cool live wallpaper, right? Well, you can create your own like this with Samsung GoodLock. What GoodLock is an application suite that contains many smaller applications for download that allow you to customize and further enhance your Samsung Galaxy device. And in this video, we'll be taking a look at the latest 2022 version. You can extend your home screen, you can adjust your notifications and your quick toggles. All kinds of customizations are available. All right, so this video is going to start you from scratch, assuming you don't know anything. Let's go ahead and start with getting it installed. So we won't be installing it with the Google Play Store. We're actually going to open up the Galaxy Store. Just start typing Galaxy. There we go. It's the first option there. Click that. All right, we're going to look for GoodLock real quick. Start typing in GoodLock. All right, go ahead and click on that. You can see there's more than one option. The one you want is the one that's right on top. The icon's going to look like that. Go ahead and click on that. Install. All right, we'll go ahead and open it up. So we're now at the main home screen for GoodLock, and there's two of them actually. There's one for unit and one for family. And you'll see here that we have little mini applications that you can download for each one of these, which I've already done. So when you first get to this screen, you'll have to install each one of these one at a time. You'll just click on it. It'll take you to the Galaxy Store, and you'll go ahead and click install. And then when you go back to the screen, it's going to show up looking like this. I recommend you install all of them. And the reason I say that is because I have mine forced to be multi-window, and you can do that here by going into settings. I'll show you what I mean. I have them forced to be landscape, is what I'm trying to say. So if you go to advanced features, go to labs, auto rotate apps, you're going to go down here and you'll do GoodLock itself. There it is. You see, I have it set to full screen instead of app default. And then there are a few of the individual GoodLock applications, for example, Keys Cafe, which allows you to customize your keyboard. That'll go to portrait by default, but you can switch that to be full screen and that'll keep it in landscape mode, which is great for this like presentation. I also tend to use a tablet in landscape mode anyway, so it's helpful to just put each one of them in there. All right, so back to GoodLock. Let's go ahead and open up the first module. This one's called LockStar. As the name implies, this is to do with your lock screen. Let's go ahead and start that. We have it turned on. We can edit the portrait screen lock screen, edit the landscape lock screen, and we can set a customized lock screen timeout, which is pretty cool. It's kind of like your screen timeout, but now for your lock screen. We click on each one. We can basically customize everything about this, including the wallpaper, the position, the clock that we're using, right? We can pick on that. We can pick which items that we want to show. Look at our list here. We have help text, status bar, all that type of stuff. Like I said, we can pick the position that it's going to float down to. Very cool. Let's go ahead and back out of here. Same with the landscape mode lock screen. You have the same functionality. All right, let's go back out. Let's move on to MultiStar. Galaxy Tablet is just going to take you to a couple things that are now available in the Samsung settings, like wireless keyboard share and the rotating, like I just showed you under labs. Samsung Dex. You can turn on all rotating apps and Dex, which is now available by default for the Tab S8 Ultra, but now you can do this with other Galaxy devices. The limit for the number of applications that you run on one time on a screen on Dex is 5, but you can go ahead and bypass that by turning on this next toggle, the second one. And the last option is auto open last app, which will do just as the name implies. It will automatically open the last app that you were using in Dex. All right, we go back here. We have other options here as well, like quick launch of the multi-window, multi-window screen zoom, multi-focus, remove blur effect on adjusting split view, pop-up view action, prevent pop-up view minimization, enable multi-window to all apps, and enable multi-window, immersive mode, and app size stretching are now features that are in the Samsung settings. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at Home Up. This is a home screen customization service. All right, we'll go ahead and turn that on. And our first option is a home screen, which is going to allow us to do a lot of adjustments here. We can adjust our grid. We can go all the way up to 12 by 12. Let's go ahead and see what that looks like real quick. Let's go ahead and apply that. We'll go to the home. Look at how small my icons are. They're all up here at top because it's going to fit 12. Wow, that's pretty nuts. All right, let's go ahead and switch that setting back. And I was running 6x5. Apply, go back home. There's the icons and that grid. All right, let's go back. You can do the same for your app screen grid. You can also set the maximum count for your number of favorites. You can choose to loop the pages. Here, I'll show you what that does real quick. We'll just demo a few of these as we're going along. Just keep an eye on what page we're on here on the applications, right? We'll just keep going. it'll just keep going back, right? So you can loop through them. Binder access, background blur control, background color control. You can basically change all the different aspects of your home screen. This will have a lot to do if you're not using a custom wallpaper. You can also back up and restore your settings. You have a share manager and a task changer. All right, let's go to the next module. All right, next up we have NotiStar. Let's go ahead and start this. Activate NotiStar. So what NotiStar is, or Notification Star, is basically a service that'll run in your background that you can specify which apps you want it to monitor, and it'll basically keep an exhaustive list of all the notifications that have happened for each one of these apps. So it'll basically produce a history. So you can come back here and check on all the applications that have started up on your machine and have an audit history of all of them. And those notifications would be back here on the main page of it. All right, next up we have QuickStar. So what this allows us to do is basically adjust our quick toggles panel. That would be down here, right? These are all of our quick toggles for our settings. So you can adjust this entire panel right here. Style your own quick panel. Turn this on. Let's try this one out real quick. Okay. Look at our quick toggles now. Pretty cool, huh? So it's got this new theme going on, and you can fine tune every one of these colors to your liking. I'm gonna go ahead and turn it back off. And you'll see the quick toggles went back to their default. That's the thing, guys. If you ever get stuck in a certain situation with any of these little apps inside GoodLock, just go back in and turn it off, or just uninstall that little part of the applet and you'll be fine. We can also adjust the visibility of different indicators like our mobile data signal, our network icons, alarm, volume, our Wi-Fi, airplane mode, Bluetooth, all these different things. You can customize each and every one of these. You have additional settings for your clock and where you want to put them on the screen. You can adjust the notifications, whether or not they're coming in by last update or the most recent that have come in. You can show a grid for your quick buttons, and you can also combine the quick toggle into settings into one to where you're not having to swipe down twice. It'll just be all in one. All right, guys, next up is going to be NavStar. Go ahead and click on this. This is a navigation bar service that allows us to further customize the navigation bar. You can see here we can customize the transparent hints, the gesture handles, as well as adjust the swipe gestures and the buttons down below. All right, so a cool way to customize your navigation bar. Next up we have NiceShot. All right, let's go ahead and click on that. So NiceShot allows you to customize your screenshots and your screen recorder experience. You'll see I have one of the options on already, and that is do not disturb during screen recording, which is very nice, which means I won't have all these doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doos while I'm doing the screen recording with you guys. Working from the top, we do not copy image to the clipboard when saving. Disable crop snapping, add a delete button to your screenshots so you can quickly delete them on the fly instead of having to go into your gallery to do it. Selfie video options, let's go ahead and click on that. Make the background color transparent. You can add some other effects here once you do. And you can also limit the selfie video size. You can see here it's medium. You can set it to small to large. And like I mentioned earlier, do not disturb during screen recording. I have that on right now. All right, the last one in the unit section of GoodLock is Routines Plus. And what this is an additional service on top of Bixby Routines that allows you to do even more advanced routines than what you can do by default in settings. So you can do location-based quick access, which gives you these options here. So we have if-then conditions, so you can adjust the actual button actions, which is really cool because you have limited options and settings of what you can do there. And if we go back here, you can run a touch macro, kind of like running VBA macros in Excel. It'll have a start-stop button, and basically you just go through and pick which actions you want it to do, and then you hit stop, and it will replay that macro and do those actions. Which I guess this is kind of handy for testing situations or in a scenario where you just don't have a routine available for Bixby. And this will allow you to create your own for any type of instance of what you're doing. Fingerprints to website and low battery announcement. So if you're getting down to a certain percentage, it'll say it out loud to you so you know to get this bad boy on the charger. You can export your routine, share via QR code, and you can import save routines. This is handy if you make it on one device and you want to share it with all the other devices. Here's a quick way to share them amongst all of them. All right, we're going to go over to the family section. All right, guys, we're now on the family screen of Samsung GoodLock, and our first option is Keys Cafe. We'll go ahead and click on that. And Keys Cafe basically lets you make your own and style your own keyboard, as well as create your own emoji type stickers, play a keyboard game, and you can do all kinds of advanced keyboard settings. Let's go ahead and take a look at this. Let's go ahead and enable this. Click on here. We can start with an English keyboard. And we can do a full edit here, and you'll see we have every type of key imaginable that we can now assign to our main keyboard here. Let's go ahead and back out of here because I don't want to make any adjustments here. We can also enable some symbol keyboards, like there's already a math keyboard here. We can enable this, and you can see it's basically set up for math equations by default. You can click apply and save that as a keyboard. You can go in here and customize your own keyboard. And if you look here, you have all these different themes and colors that you can pick for your keyboard. You can enable different effects, like pulsating effects right here, right? And you can enable sounds for your different key presses while you're doing it. So if we go back here to like effects, for example, let's go ahead and pick this effect here. And we will go ahead and try the keyboard right here. Look at that effect. You see it on the keyboard? Pretty cool, huh? Not bad at all. And under the advanced settings, we have long spacebar while URL typing, auto replacement sensitivity, and double tap interval of 3x4 keyboards. All right, so let's go ahead and exit out of Keys Cafe. Now we're going to open up Wonderland. And what Wonderland is basically a wallpaper customization service. You see here that I'm using this wallpaper right here. So we can go ahead and pick any one of these, like landscape, set as wallpaper, home and lock screen. There we go. It's kind of a 3D-ish looking wallpaper. Yeah, I kind of like that a lot. And you can go back in here and edit these as well. So you can also create a new one. We start from the gallery. We can pick a different color if we want. Here we'll do this wild green. Click save. Give it a name. Test. Set as wallpaper. Home and lock screen. All right, there we go. We have this green, wild, bright wallpaper. I'm gonna go ahead and switch this back and go back to the main good lock screen. All right, so next up is NiceCatch. NiceCatch is very similar to NotiStar right here in that it's basically another auditing program. Here, I'll show you. We'll go ahead and turn this on, right? So anything, and this is all for your sounds that come in. So it's all your vibration history, every time the ringer mode has changed, calls have come in, all your notification toasts, basically any type of thing that would activate a vibration or sound, NiceCatch will capture, and you can basically traverse the log through all of them. So it's just a way for you to audit everything that's been happening on your device. So next up we have SoundAssistant. All right, so what SoundAssistant is an application that allows you to adjust your volume panel and a lot of the other audio features on your device. So if we click on this, it's off right now. We turn it on, you see here we can fully customize it. Boom, you can do this and you have the expanded panel that you can adjust to. And you can fine tune each one of these. All right, we'll exit out of here. Make your own volume panel colors. You see here you can totally customize it to your liking. Let's go ahead and try a theme here. Okay, it's using Theme Park to apply it. Let's see if it worked. So we click on this, look at that, click on these. There's the whole volume panel right there. That's pretty awesome. I like the look of that actually. All right guys, up next is Pentastic. This is a customization service for your S Pen. As you can see here, it's pretty cool. You can basically, here, let's demo this real quick. So by default, when you pull up the S Pen, you have this right here. Let's go ahead and change this out. We can do a compact view, You have all these different adjustments, including using air commands. All right. We'll do the background, we'll adjust the brightness, the blur. Okay, let's go ahead and give it a try. Look at that. Pops up all down the bottom. I like that. That's pretty cool. Let's go ahead and try another one. We've got this circle one. Okay. Check it out. We have that little circle wheel there. Let's pop it up down here. Cool. I like that a lot. So you can basically customize your S Pen experience however you want. You can even adjust your double tap shortcuts. And these shortcuts can be used to do all these actions as well as call up any one of these applications. In addition to that, you can adjust your pointer. As you can see here, we can adjust this one, use this pointer, use. And now as you hover above the screen, it's gonna look a little bit different. Let's make it bigger so you guys can really see it. You see this big pointer underneath it? Hopefully it's showing it. Let me get my hand out of the way. You guys can see it. See that big pointer? All right, let's go ahead back to the default use. So now we're back to the default pointer. You can adjust the sound when you're doing different actions as well. Next up, we have Theme Park. This one we almost kind of need to do a whole separate tutorial on. Let's go ahead and check this out real quick. And as the name implies, you basically could make your own theme. So you could start here with a new one. I have a previous one. This allows you to adjust your keyboard, your quick panel, your icons as well, your volume panel. This was a lot of the different functionality that we covered in the other little applications. Well, you can kind of take care of all of that right here in Theme Park. You can start out by creating a new theme. All right, you can use a current wallpaper or gallery. We'll go ahead and pick current. It's gonna pick the most current one that's in your regular wallpaper list, not necessarily the one I have from GoodLock. So we'll go ahead and click done. All right, we click next. It's loading the image. Now it's asking us to pick a whole bunch of stuff. We can basically change the whole color aspect of our theme. You see here, and you move on and just basically customize your whole entire device. We'll do a separate video on this one because this one will take a lot of time to cover. Theme Park is very exhaustive once you start really diving into each one of the settings. And last but not least for Samsung GoodLock is One Hand Operation Plus. Go ahead and click on this. Let's turn the service on. And what this does is let you set up handles that are basically shortcuts like these gestures we have down here below to use this as a one-handed device. And as you see here, if we click on it, if you do a straight swipe, we get the back key. A diagonal up, we get the recent key, and a diagonal down, we get the back key. So this is very helpful for those of you that just want to keep the device in one hand and just keep doing this to get around your different applications. You have different app exceptions for which apps you don't want to interact with this. You have different animations, landscape mode, whether or not you want S Pen gestures to work with it, fit to keyboard, hide it on your lock screen, hide in your quick panel, different gesture settings as well. And you have the width and height of the different left and right hand side gesture panels as well. And you can turn on a vibration level just to give you some indication that you're actually using it. All right, guys, so as you can see here, Samsung GoodLock is a very comprehensive set of little applications that allow you to further extend your Samsung Galaxy device. If you guys have any more questions on this, or if there's any one of these applets that you want me to dive into further, like just do a full coverage, just let me know. All right, guys, as always, thanks for watching.